So in the previous sessions, we saw problem on circular convolution. In that problem, the length of two sequences were equal. Now let us take up a problem in which the length of two sequences is different. Okay. So how to solve a problem in circular convolution if the lengths are different? So the question is, perform circular convolution of x of n 1, 3, 5, 7 and h of n 4 and 8. Now let us take the length of x of n as n1. So the number of samples which we have is 4, so n1 will be equal to 4. Similarly, let the length of h of n be equal to n2, so the length is 2. So whenever the lengths are different, in order to find out the length of the circular convoluted sequence, the formula which we use is n, which is equal to maximum of n1 comma n2. Okay. Now, the value of n1 and n2 is nothing but 4 and 2. Looking into these two values, the maximum value is 4. Therefore, the value of n is 4. We need to take the maximum value out of n1 and n2. Here, the maximum value is 4. So, I have taken it as 4. Now, what I need to do is, I need to approximate the length of h of n to 4. But how many samples we have in the given data? We have only 2 samples, but the length should be equal to 4. So what I need to do is, I need to append few zeros in order to make the length as 4. Since we have 2 samples, in order to make it as 4, how many zeros should I add? I need to add 2 zeros. So if I add 2 zeros at the end of h of n, makes the length of h of n as 4. So this is how we can make the length equal and we can continue to find out circular convolution. Okay, I will directly go for the easiest method, that is matrix method, and I will show how to find out the circular convolution. So in matrix method, the first matrix which I am going to write is x of n, that is 1 3 5 7. The next column, the first element will be 7, and shift 1 here, again 3 here and 5 here. Okay. Now the last element should be written first. Shift 7, 1 and 3. Again, what is the last element? It is 3. Then shift 5 here, 7 and 1. So shift until the first element becomes the last element. Okay. So I have shifted here, we had 1, and here also we got as 1. Now, what is the second sequence which we have? The second sequence is 4, 8, 0 and 0. Now, I need to perform matrix multiplication. In order to do so, the column of first matrix should match the row of second matrix. Yes, it is matching. So, I can start multiplying. So, if I start multiplying, so multiplying 1 with 4 gives us 4, plus multiplying 7 with 8 gives us 56. Multiplying 5 with 0 is 0. Multiplying 3 with 0 is also 0. So moving on to the next row, 3 into 4 is 12, plus 1 into 8 is 8. Similarly, moving on to this, 5 into 4 is 20. 3 8s are 24. Now moving on to the next one, 28, 5 with 8, 40. So rest of the multiplication gives us 0, so I am not at all writing that. So now let us simplify this and let us write. So if I write, 50 plus 4 is 60, 12 plus 8 is 20, 20 plus 24 is 44, 28 plus 40 is 68. So what is the circular convoluted sequence? It is nothing but 60, 20, 44 and 68. We know x of n was equal to x, 1 of n was equal to x of n circular convolution with h of n. So if I write the sequence, x1 of n is nothing but equal to 60, 20, 44 and 68. So why have taken it as x of n? Because in the given question they have termed it as x of n. So I took this as x1 of n. Whichever variable you want, you can take other than the given variable in the question. So this is how you can simplify or find out circular convolution when the length of given sequence are different. We completed circular convolution problems. Now let us move on to circular shift in time and frequency domain problems. So the first question is, if x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3 by 4, 1 by 2, find y of n if their DFTs are related as y of k, which is equal to omega 4 to the power of 3k into x of k. Now let us write the given relationship. So if I write the given relationship, so y of k, which is equal to omega 4 to the power of 3k into x of k. So if I write this omega in terms of exponential, I can write it as e power minus j 2 pi 3k divided by 4 into x of k. Now looking into this relation, what I can make out, this is nothing but the frequency domain term, multiplication of frequency domain term. It is similar to which property? It is similar to circular shift in time domain. Whenever we shift in time domain, then the exponential term will be multiplied in frequency domain. So from that property, I need to simplify this and I need to find out what is y of n with the help of this particular relationship. So what we know, the circular shift in time domain is given by x of n minus m of n, which is equal to e power minus j 2 pi k m by n into x of k. So we have studied this property in the previous classes. Now I need to compare this and I need to solve this particular problem. From this I will start solving the problem. What I need to do is, I need to apply DFT to this equation. So if I apply DFT to this equation, what we are going to get? We get this particular sequence. How? So in property we saw, if I apply DFT to this, we are going to get this. Now, what they have done? They have given this and they are telling us to prove this with the help of this, try to find out y of n. Okay? Now, I will continue this. In order to do so, I will term this equation as equation number 1. So if I apply circular shift property to equation 1, so I can rewrite it as y of k can be written as y of n, which is equal to, instead of this term, I need to write it like this. So it is x of n minus, what is the value of m we have? So compare this term, we have e power minus j 2 pi k m by n. Here it is e power minus j 2 pi 3k by 4. The value of k is equal to 3. Write it as 3. What is the value of n? Here it is n in the denominator. So the value of n is 4. With the help of circular shift in time domain, with this relation, we deduced this relation. Now what let us do? Let us try to simplify this by substituting the values for n. Since the value of capital N is 4, we know small n ranges from 0 to n minus 1. Therefore, the value of n should be 0, 1, 2 and 3. So now I will substitute directly in this equation and let us try to simplify. So y of n will be equal to x of, I can rewrite this as 4 plus n minus 3. Now in this particular term, let us start substituting the values of n. So if I do so, if n is equal to 0, y of 0 will be equal to x of 4 plus 0 minus 3. Okay. So 4 minus 3 is 1. So this is nothing but equal to x of 1. Coming back to the given data, so this is your x of n. So the first term is r, x of 0, second is x of 1, third is x of 2 and fourth is x of 3. So what is your y of 0 equal to? It is equal to x of 1. What is the value of x of 1? It is nothing but equal to 2. So substitute it here.
So y of 0 is equal to 2.
We found out y of 0. Now let us find out the next one.
If n is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of 4 plus 1 minus 3.
Okay. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5 minus 3 is 2.
So this gives us x of 2.
From simplification, we came to know that y of 1 is equal to x of 2. What is the value of x of 2 from the given data? X of 2 is equal to 3 by 4. Therefore, y of 1 is equal to 3 by 4. Now, let us give the next value. That is, if n is equal to 2,
y of 2 is equal to x of 4 plus 2 minus 3.
4 plus 2 is 6. 6 minus 3 is 3.
Which is equal to x of 3.
From simplification, y of 2 is equal to x of 3. What is x of 3? X of 3 is nothing but 1 by 2.
So, y of 2 is equal to 1 by 2.
The last value for n, what I should give? As 3.
So, if n is equal to 3, y of 3 will be equal to x of 4 plus 3 minus 3, which is equal to
plus 3 gets cancelled with minus 3.
So, it is nothing but equal to x of 4.
And since it is circular shift, the sequence keeps on repeating. So, after x of 3, this will be your x of 4. That is, your x of 0 is same as your x of 4. So, what is the value which you have? 1. So, substitute it as 1. Therefore, y of 3 is equal to 1. So, we gave all the 4 values of n and we found out y of 0 up to y of 3.
Therefore, if I tabulate it, gives us y of n that is equal to 2, 3 by 4, 1 by 2 and 1.
So, this is how we can find out y of n with the help of circular shift in time domain. So, one thing what we can observe here is, so it is nothing but only this particular property which plays a very important role. They have given this, from this we try to deduce this, and then with the help of this we found out y of n. So, this is property related to circular shift in time domain. Moving on to the next problem in circular shift. So, the question is, if x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, find g of n if their DFTs are related as g of k, which is equal to omega 6 to the power of minus 2k into x of k. What is the difference between the previous and this problem? In the previous problem, we had positive value for omega. Now, we have negative value. So, that is one important thing which you need to keep in mind when you solve problem. So, let us write down the relationship. The relationship is g of k, which is equal to omega 6 to the power of minus 2k into x of k. If I write this in terms of exponential term, I can write it as e power minus j 2 pi minus 2k divided by 6 into x of k. So, in this relationship, so it is similar to our circular shift in time domain only because it is multiplication of exponential in frequency domain. So, shift in time domain is nothing but multiplication of exponential in frequency domain. So, I have written the formula of circular shift in time domain. Now, looking into this equation, what is the value of capital N? The value of N is 6. So, if the value of N is 6, the value of small n ranges from 0 to 5 because N ranges from 0 to N minus 1. Now, to this equation, if I apply IDFT and write back in this particular form, I can rewrite this as g of n will be equal to, instead of g of k, I have written it as g of n. Now, I need to write this entire term in this fashion. So, if I write, it will be equal to x of n minus, what is the value of m which we have? If you compare, it is 2 pi k m by n. Here it is 2 pi minus 2k by n. Okay, the value of m is minus 2. So, it is minus 2 of
n. The value of n is 6. So if I simplify and rewrite, I can write this as x of n minus into minus plus 2 of 6. Or I can write this as x of 6 plus n plus 2.
Now let us start giving the values for n and let us find out g of n. Okay.
So if the value of n is equal to 0, g of 0 will be equal to x of 6 plus 0 plus 2, so which is equal to x of 8.
Okay. Since the circular shift again, if you term this, it will be x of 0, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4 and x of 5. Okay, after 5, x of 6 comes here, x of 7 comes here, this is your x of 8. So what is the value of x of 8? It is nothing but equal to 3. So g of 0 is equal to x of 8, which is equal to 3. So we are done with the first substitution.
So the second substitution is, if n is equal to 1, g of 1 is equal to x of 6 plus 1 plus 2. So this is nothing but equal to x of 9.
Okay. So what is the value of x of 9? So this was your x of 8. The next value will be your x of 9 and the value is 4. Therefore, g of 1 is equal to x of 9, which is equal to 4.
So if I substitute the next value, that is if n is equal to 2, g of 2 will be equal to x of 6 plus 2 plus 2. So x of 10. What is x of 10? It will be equal to 5. Similarly, if n is equal to 3, g of 3 will be equal to x of 6 plus 3 plus 2 is equal to x of 11, which is equal to 6.
Okay.
Similarly, substitute the values up till n is equal to 5. When n is equal to 4, g of 4 will be equal to x of 12 and the value will be equal to 1. Similarly, if n is equal to 5, g of 5 will be equal to x of 13, that is equal to 2.
Now I have substituted the values of n from 0 to 5. If I tabulate, all this gives us g of 0.
Therefore, g of n is equal to, the first value is g of 0 is 3, g of 1 is 4, g of 2 is 5, g of 3 is 6, g of 4 is 1, g of 5 is 2. So this is nothing but g of n.
Okay. The next type of problem in circular shift is, they have given x of n and they are telling us to find out y of n and they have given the relationship. So if I take down the relationship, y of k will be equal to omega 2 to the power of k into x of k. So if I rewrite this, it is nothing but equal to e power minus j 2 pi k divided by 2 into x of k.
Okay.
Looking into this, the denominator value of the exponential term gives us the value of n. So here the value of n is nothing but 2, but the number of samples given here is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Always the value of n is nothing but the number of samples. It should match, but according to the given relationship, the value of n is 2. In order to make it as 6, what let us do is, let us multiply and divide this particular power with 3.
So if I multiply and divide it with 3, I can rewrite this as e power minus j 2 pi 3k divided by 2 into 3 into x of k.
So in the denominator, what is the value which we are going to get? 2 3s, so it is nothing but 6. Okay. How many number of samples we have? 6. So it is matching. Now compare this with this. Now the value of m is nothing but equal to 3. I need to deduce this with the help of this. In order to do so, if I apply circular shift in time domain, I can write y of k as y of n, that is equal to x of n minus m value is 3 and the value of n is 6. I can rewrite this as x of 6 plus n minus 3. Now what I need to do, we all know the value of n is equal to 6. So the value of n ranges from 0 to n minus 1. Therefore the value of n is from 0 to 5. Give all the values of n from 0 to 5 gives us what is y of n. Let us give the first value, that is if n is equal to 0, y of 0 is equal to x of 6 plus 0 minus 3 gives us x of 3. 6 minus 3 is 3. Coming back to the given data, this is x of 0, this is x of 1, this is x of 2, this is x of 3, x of 4 and x of 5. So what is the value of x of 3? The value of x of 3 is minus 3. Therefore, y of 0 is also equal to minus 3. If the value of n is equal to 1, y of 1 will be equal to x of 6 plus 1 minus 3. 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 minus 3 is 4. So x of 4, which is equal to, what is the value of x of 4 from the given data? X of 4 is equal to 4. Therefore, y of 1, which is equal to x of 4, will be equal to 4. Similarly, if n is equal to 2, y of 2 will be equal to x of 6 plus 2 minus 3, which is equal to 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 minus 3 is 5, so x of 5, and the value of x of 5 is 5. So what is the next value of n which we need to substitute? It should be equal to 3. Y of 3 will be equal to x of 6 plus 3 minus 3, which is equal to x of 6. So what is x of 6? Your x of 0 is same as x of 6, therefore the value is 2. So y of 3 is equal to 2. If n is equal to 4, y of 4 is equal to x of 6 plus 4 minus 3. This is nothing but equal to x of 7. So what is the value of x of 7 from the given data? It is nothing but 0. This is equal to 0. So the last value of n which I am going to give is 5. If n is equal to 5, y of 5 is equal to x of 6 plus 5 minus 3, which is equal to x of 8, and the value of x of 8 is minus 2. So after substituting all the values, we got the values of y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, y of 3, y of 4 and y of 5. If I tabulate all those together, gives us y of n, which is equal to minus 3, 4, 5, 2, 0 and minus 2. So this is nothing but y of n, which we found out with the help of circular shift in time domain formula. So what are the three different kinds of problems which we saw now? One, the power of omega, what they gave was positive in the first problem. In the second problem, it was negative. And in the third problem, the value of n is differing from this and from the number of samples what they have given. So keep these three types in mind and start solving similar kinds of problems. The next problem is they have given x1 of n and its DFT, and they have given x2 of n and they are telling us to find out x2 of k. Okay. Now looking into the sequence of x1 of n and x2 of n, this is x1 of 0, this is x1 of 1, so this is x1 of 2 and this is x1 of 3. Similarly, if I come to x2 of n, so this is x2 of 0, x2 of 1, x2 of 2, x2 of 3. So comparing these two sequences, So it is starting from 1, and then here you have 1 by 2, there you have minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2 is nothing but x1 of 3 according to x1 of n sequence. Now, relating these two things with the relationship, I can write x2 of n is nothing but equal to x1 of n minus n. Okay, let us check. What is the value of n? We have 4 samples. So the value of n is 4. If n is 4, the range of n will be from 0 to n minus 1. So which is equal to 0 to 3. Okay. Now, if I substitute the value of n as 4, it will be x1 of 4. If n is 0, x2 of 0 will be equal to x1 of 4 minus 0. X1 of 4 minus 0 is nothing but x1 of 4. What is x1 of 4 equal to? It is nothing but equal to x1 of 0. So what is the value? 1. So are you getting x2 of 0 as the same value? Yes. Now, the second thing is, if n is equal to 1, x2 of 1 will be equal to x1 of 4 minus 1. So x1 of 4 minus 1 is nothing but equal to x1 of 3. What is the data for x1 of 3? It is nothing but equal to minus 1 by 2. The same thing you have there. So it is nothing but the shifted version. X2 of n is nothing but the shifted version of x1 of n. Now, if I rewrite this equation, I can write it as x1 of minus n of n. Okay. So, if we apply DFT to this, I can write this equation as x2 of k, which is equal to x1 of minus k of n. So, in the next step, what we can do? I need to give the values of k and I need to simplify in order to find out what is x2 of k. This is the equation which we are going to get after applying DFT to this. Then we know the value of n is 4. Substituting the values of k, we also know k ranges from 0 to n minus 1. So k will be equal to 0 to 3. Substituting the values of k in this equation as we did in the previous problem. So this is the result which we are going to get, and this is nothing but the value for x2 of k. So this completes the problems on properties of DFT. So finally, module 1 is done. We will start module 2 in the next session. Thank you.